द मॉन्टी ग्लानी मिलर अप्रोच टू डिविडेंड थ्योरीज। नाउ बेसिकली टू डिविडेंड पॉलिसी एंड हाउ डिविडेंड पॉलिसी इज इम्पैक्टिंग द प्राइस ऑफ द शेयर एंड इन टर्न इम्पैक्टिंग द वैल्यूएशन ऑफ द फर्म। Now the MM approach says that dividend decisions are irrelevant to the firm in the sense that even if cash dividends are distributed by the firm, the distribution of cash dividend leads to a fall in the cash flows of the company. And if available investment opportunities require more funds, new issue of equity has to be done by the firm. Now, with the assumptions of strictly perfect capital markets, no transaction cost, no brokerage, same level of growth and investment opportunities, what we find is that when a firm issues more shares, issues fresh equity in the market, then the supply of shares increases, which leads to an overall fall in the price of the share, in the value of the share. So whatever was gained by the shareholder in form of cash dividends received by the firm is completely sorry, not only the cash dividends, but say there has been an increase in the market value when the dividends were announced. So if that increase took place, it is completely offset when these cash dividends are distributed, leading to a fall in the cash funds with the company and subsequent increase in the supply of the shares. So ultimately, the company remains at the same position. There's a status quo, and hence dividends are irrelevant to the firm. What is relevant is the investment opportunities available to it. So we had done step-by-step calculation of the valuation of firm and taking both the cases, one where dividend is declared, second where dividend is not declared. Ultimately, under both the cases, we get the same valuation for the firm. Not only in the current time period, but also 1 year hence. So, on the same lines, you have a question on your screen. Diamond Engineering Company has 10 lakh equity shares outstanding at the start of accounting year. The ruling market price per share is rupees 150. So, this is P0. That is the price at 0 point of time. This is N, the existing number of shares in the market. The company is contemplating declaring 8 rupees as a dividend at the end of current year. So this is your D1. The rate of capitalization is 12%. So there are three parts in this question. Starting with the first part, you need to calculate the market price of the share when the contemplated dividend is declared or not declared. So what you need to calculate is P1 under both the cases, and the formula for that will be so using the values in the question, you will calculate P1 under both the cases when dividend is declared and one when dividend is not declared. The second part says how many shares are to be issued by the company at the end of accounting year. Assuming that net income for the year is 2 crore while investment budget is 4 crore. So again, you need to take both the cases, one where D1 is 0, second where D1 1 is rupees 8. So you are now calculating delta N in this part, which is equal to the investment outlay minus the earnings plus ND1 upon 1 plus KE. So again you apply the value on both the sides and you will get the number of shares to be distributed, right, to be issued. Then the C part shows that the total market value will remain the same at the end of accounting year, whether dividends are distributed or not. Also find out the current market value of the firm under both conditions. So now you need to calculate R. R is nothing but the number of shares in the market after the fresh issue. So RP naught, this is number of shares in the market post the issue. So now this is M plus delta E. So for each of the formula you are applying, you will have two parts. Start with the question, then we discuss the solution. I'll ask you people for the answer. So please, everyone, start solving.
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम
हाँ जी प्रणव बोलो।
मैम, जब हम न्यू शेयर्स इशू कितने करने हैं ये देख रहे हैं, तो इसमें डिवाइड बाय मार्केट प्राइस नहीं होगा? प्रेजेंट मार्केट प्राइस
अच्छा हाँ सॉरी, मैं आई मेक द करेक्शन, डिवाइडेड बाय P1 होगा, प्रेजेंट नहीं फ्यूचर एक्सपेक्टेड, क्योंकि ये आप आगे फ्यूचर में करोगे इश्यू।
ओके मैम। मैम जो सी पार्ट में हम वैल्यू निकाल रहे हैं फर्म की, ये हम
हाँ,
प्रेजेंट वैल्यू निकाल रहे होते हैं फ्यूचर वैल्यू?
इसमें हम एक में प्रेजेंट निकालते हैं, एक में फ्यूचर निकालते हैं।
ओके मैम।
जिसमें प्रेजेंट निकालते हैं उसमें 1 प्लस KE करोगे आप, मतलब डिस्काउंटिंग करोगे अपॉन 1 प्लस KE, क्योंकि ये आपकी 1 ईयर के बाद का है ना, यहाँ पे आना। Okay, now you can continue. टेक वन लास्ट मिनट एंड देन वी डिस्कस द सॉल्यूशन. Okay, so let's start with the first step, which is the calculation. First part of the question, calculation of the market price per share when dividend is declared. So yes, what is the answer? Put in the chat box. How much is P0 when dividend is declared? Okay, excellent. So when dividend is declared, the price is 160, and when dividend is not declared, the price is 168. So ultimately, as discussed earlier also, the earnings of the shareholder, they remain the same irrespective of whether the dividend is declared or not. Let's move to the second part, which is the number of shares to be issued when D1 is equal to 0 and when D1 is equal to 8. So okay, so when dividends are distributed, then I'll check the answer also. Rest of you also attempt. So this is 1,75,000. When dividends are distributed, so obviously when you are distributing dividends, you will have to issue higher number of shares to meet your fund requirement, and when you are not distributing dividends, then by issuing lower number of shares you can meet your fund requirement. So 1,19,047.62, that is the number of shares that you need to issue when dividends are not distributed. Okay, so how much is the price coming at point P0? 15 cr, which is again equal, approximately equal. There might be 20-30 rupee difference, that's fine. 50-60 rupees, 100 rupees, that's absolutely fine, because one of the cases is giving you number of shares in decimal value, so that is perfectly fine. And in the second case, within this part, that what will be the value of the company at the end of year one. दिस इज कमिंग टू हाउ मच, 16.8 Okay, so this is almost equal to 16.8. I hope you have taken the total number of shares. So as per book, it is coming to 18.8. So please recheck your calculation. You have 11,75,000 shares when dividends are distributed. Yes, so please make sure your calculations are correct. This is coming to 18.8 crores. So we are able to prove the theory and the irrelevance of dividends for valuation of the firm. Okay, so let's move further. Let's take up one more question from the theory. Now, this question has come in your past paper 2019. Please solve it carefully. A company belongs to risk class for which the capitalization rate is 10%. So your KE is 10%. It's currently having 25,000 shares. This is N. Selling at 100 each, P0. The firm is contemplating the declaration of dividend of rupees 5 at the end of the current financial year, and the income earnings of the company are expected to be 2.5 lakh, whereas investment requirement is 5 lakh, so that under assumptions, the payment of dividend does not impact the value of firm. So last time when we had offline exams, it was in 2019, and this was a question from that year. So start solving, everyone. Apart from the two students who are answering, others also solve. We'll discuss.
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम,
हाँ जी प्रणत, बताओ।
लास्ट क्वेश्चन में जो आंसर्स आ रहे थे मेरे डिविडेंड नॉट पेड वाले सिनेरियो में तो सेम नहीं आ रहे हैं, ओनली डिविडेंड पेड वाले में मैच कर रहे हैं, मतलब आंसर अलग
नहीं,
अलग
नॉट
आ
पेड में कितना डिफरेंस आ रहा है आपका?
रहे हैं। मैम नॉट पेड में 1 करोड़ से अबव का डिफरेंस आ रहा है।
1 CR से आपका नहीं होना चाहिए। आप ऐसा करो, आप मेरे साथ एक बारी सॉल्यूशन शेयर करो अपना व्हाट्सएप पे, मैं तब तक करती हूँ। बाय दैट टाइम प्लीज सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन। ओके,
ओके मैम।
तो ब्रनन दैट इज 11,19,000। आपने 90 उसमें कुछ गलती कर दी। ओके ओके लेट्स डिस्कस दिस सॉल्यूशन। तो हाउ मच इज द प्राइस कमिंग अंडर द केस व्हेन डिविडेंड इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड एंड व्हेन डिविडेंड इज नॉट डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड। व्हाट इज द प्राइस ऑफ शेयर व्हेन डिविडेंड इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड P1। हंड्रेड एंड फाइव एंड हंड्रेड एंड टेन। देन सेकेंड स्टेप इज कैलकुलेशन ऑफ डेल्टा एन, दैट इज द न्यू शेयर्स विच नीड टू बी इशू फंड रिक्वायरमेंट्स ऑफ द फर्म। सो आई एम राइटिंग द आंसर्स, प्लीज वेरीफाई साइड बाय साइड। Yes, delta n is coming to 3571.428 or 43 if you rounded it, then it's okay. Here it is 272.72.73. When the value of the firm when at the end of year one will come out to be 30 lakh and value of the firm at the end of year zero or basically at present is coming to 25 lakh. So again, for every practical question, give a closing statement, give a conclusion that carries marks. So you will write, hence under the MM approach, we are able to prove that market valuation of the firm remains the same both at present and in future, irrespective of dividend payment. Therefore, dividend decisions are irrelevant to the firm.